2 race, Australian Tour kicks off at the Calder Park Thunderdome. Winning the Delano Pole Award is Melanie Clavino in the Hodges Walter Racing Ilona car. On the outside of the front row is Luciano Savarol in his Lennard, car number 5. Row number 2, Arto Kekkonen. In that car number 9, he's shown a lot of speed, but no wins this year. Gasper D'Souza has 2 wins on the season. Kurt Pliskin and Leonard Roderick in row 3. Davina Henton has a new paint job. Zelda Ashby on the outside of row 4. Woodard and Bates in row 5. Jacob Card's been quick all week, as is Kevin Dwyer. Carlos Requeto won earlier in the year at Quincy. Hannah Percy is making her first start down under, and Jack Dempsey is making his series debut in a points race, as is Russell Jones on the outside of row 11. Alessandro Rossini is probably looking for more from his qualifying effort. Adrian Devereaux all the way down in 24th. What's he doing back there? Axel Andersson and Lewis Kingston are impressed with their efforts. John Dilks makes his return to the series after quite a long layoff in car 29. It's a bright green car, will be easy to spot. Daniel Melrose in car 67 in his home race was looking for a little more than that. However, he outqualified both of his regular drivers, Peter Short and Matthias Taub. Kurt Reynolds and Dan Legland are probably looking for a little more than what they wound up with. And there you see the Velocity Motorsports entries. They actually bought out the Maximus Racing entries because Maximus did not make the trip down under. And as you see right there, Dalton Johnson ran practice only but was replaced after practice 1 by Mason Yokoyama. Got a problem with one car, and it's Jacob Card. Jacob Card is having problems on the pace lap, and car number 6 does not look like it's going to be taking the green. Card is... That's not going to go well for Jacob Card, who about a year ago looked like he was set to, well, big disappointment early for Lennard International. And Luciano Savarol has already lost ground in their other car. Right off the bat is Melanie Clavino rocketed off the line, as you saw while I was yammering about Card. But Clavino has got a pretty big lead, and she's going to lead the first lap. Can't really say it's a surprise when you start on the inside going into turn 1. Kekkonen getting around. Oh, we got a crash in the back. There's one look at it. Rossini. Packer Carroll shoving Rossini down. And we got, Dilks involved. Melrose involved. Russell Jones. Ian Cooper. Lewis Kingston in the other Manicor car, but that was a little uncalled for. Rossini's forcing a 3 wide. And you see, Packer's not giving him a whole lot of room. Packer's trying to force him to back off, which if you're going to play games like that, that's a little too early for that now. Now that's where that gets a little uncalled for, when Packer ran him down practically to the paint. And that's the Packer Carroll of old, but really, I don't think either one of those guys should have been running that aggressively this early. That's a little... You see, Rossini's got space. But Packer Carroll is not giving him a whole lot of room. On board with John Dilks in car 29. And that's not really what we want to see this early in the race. Oh, Melrose looks like he got through that, actually, in the 67 car. But that looks like John Dilks' return to the series is going to be over fairly quickly after that. Car 29 out, and he's actually taken over the Independence Trophy bid of Spannerhead Racing, which failed to show up for any of the 2 special events, and their entry was tossed. Ian Masterson picked it up, and John Dilks brought a car here. And we got a restart here, as you saw there, the whole field pitted practically to check for tire wear, because this race, we did have rain earlier in the day. This was supposed to be a day race, however, as you can see here, not daytime. As you see here, Kekkonen having a run on Clavino, so the whole field is checking for tire wear, how it would go after one lap. Because you have to start the race on the same tires you qualified on. And some people were trying to get off those tires, obviously, because maybe they thought they were a bit too soft. Pliskin looking in that 16 car. That's a one-off sponsor deal on Pliskin's car. When we get to the next race at Surfers Paradise, Pliskin will have another one-off sponsor deal, we believe. Ash Bridges in car number 360 in the second Velocity car. See, Velocity Motorsports actually has somewhat of a pain. Oh, whoa! Lecklider gets into the back of Bridges. What? And Bridges, he's got it on the grass. Slow. Oh, stay down, stay down, stay down. Oh, my goodness. Mason Yokoyama, Code Brown. Mason Yokoyama, the 97 car. Massive Code Brown. And that's not the first time this weekend that's happened to him. Mason Yokoyama got in this car after Dalton Johnson was running very, very slowly in it. And immediately, Yokoyama was about a second and a half quicker than Johnson. But that car is still well, well off the pace. And Ash Bridges, what on earth is he doing? Ash Bridges is on the inside. He's on the apron, but he's not coming into the pit lane. I can't really explain that one, but I would imagine somebody has to be on his radio telling him to get off the racetrack. And he's on the apron, still hasn't hit the pit lane, as we see Kevin Dwyer running up in fifth place, gotten around Greg Woodard in the 41. Here's the two Black Diamond Racing teammates, the KLTV 60 car with Gaspar D'Souza. There's going to be a slightly different paint job on that car when we get to Gravis City, and that white and gold car behind him is Davina Henton running a new paint job on that car, but that'll only be at the two Australian races, at least that's how I understand it. Adrian Devereaux has moved his way up from 24th on the grid to 15th place, so he's really going places. Daniel Melrose in the 67, also somewhat of a big mover on the start, up to 28th. And Benoit Vuckler as well, up to 29th. So these two gentlemen are on their way forwards. Benoit Vuckler has been running fairly well lately, even though he missed Indianapolis. Extreme right-wing radio host, I do believe, Jack Dempsey. That's at least what he's known for down here, down in Australia. He's actually having a pretty good run so far. He's running up in 21st. This is actually Helsing's first Master Cup start. This is, of course, another one of the... Actually, Dempsey's in the points now, because that was actually the pass for 20. They made an Andersson. He's actually having a pretty good debut so far in that 341 car. Here is the 97 car, Yokoyama, going a lap down. To be honest, climbing on board Dalton Johnson's car on short notice is, that's not the easiest assignment in the world, but he's not making life any easier for everyone around him, although I think some people at the front are, that was a bit of a late block on Woodard, especially when you're a lap down, but given everything I've heard coming out from some drivers out there, they're pretty thankful that it's Yokoyama and not Johnson at the wheel of that 97 car, especially Matthias Taub, who I think had some choice words for Johnson after the round of Ohio. Melanie Clavino in car number 2 is making a run at Arto Kekkonen for the lead. No, I don't think she's got enough run. She has enough momentum to do it. Nope, she has to back off. The Alona car back to second place. She's going to try it again. Maybe she'll have a bit more momentum this time, especially with Kurt Kliskin in that 16 car right behind her. And looks like Clavino into turn 1. They're really flying around this track. They're going a lot quicker than I think anyone expected. Everyone expected this year, especially given some of the slightly different rules as far as what they're doing with the rear spoilers of these cars. And they are rather small, and I think that's helped with the quality of the racing we've seen this season. Here is Yokoyama again. He's being lapped. He's being courteous, holding his own line, but Joel Enick is... Joel Enick got stuck behind him. He got boxed in behind a lap behind the 97 car. And now I think Yokoyama did not. He's going to let the 23 go by because I don't think he wants to get that car destroyed because they have no backup car and they have to bring that same chassis to Surface Paradise. Adrian Devereaux has moved his way up to 11th. We're only on lap 27, so I'd say that Adrian Devereaux must have sacrificed qualifying entirely to work on a race setup. And if that's what he has been doing, then it's paying off. Davina Henson, car number 11, back to 14th. This has actually been a pretty good battle that we kind of missed between Davina Henson, Carlos Requeta, and Scott Stoidler in that yellow 13 car, which that car actually looks quite nice here, here under the lights, that number 13 car, and here goes Henton right on by. Got a problem with one of the Melrose Racing Team cars, and that's Matthias Taub. Oh, Reynolds and Atkins! Oh, that was almost a huge accident. Kurt Reynolds slowed up to miss Taub and nearly got sideswiped by the 50 car of Atkins, but Matthias Taub, driving one of the Melrose Racing Team cars, home team here, out. That's not going to be good for them, as Luciano Savaral has caught Arto Kekkonen and leader Melanie Clavino on lap 31 out of the 140 laps scheduled. And you see there, the five leaders here have really pulled away from Greg Woodard, who's sitting back in sixth place. And I think we might be approaching our first round of green flag pit stops before too much longer. Kevin Dwyer in that 8 car also hanging with this group as well, using that golden yellow Myasoff car, as is Kurt Pliskin's Lycoya. Actually, all the Lennard-powered cars have really had a pretty good weekend. Well, aside from Jacob Card, obviously, because Card blew up on the face lap, and that's something you don't see very often anymore. And that's still a good thing, I think. Bliskin in the 16 car, he's been having a pretty good season, despite the number of DNFs he's had. The speed is still there with, and here he goes, he's trying to get around Kevin Dwyer. Kevin Dwyer in that 8 car has really been having a good season as well. He got a win at Sweden, his first win on a road course. And I think Bliskin is going to be looking for a lot, especially when the series hits a couple of the tracks coming up. Surface Paradise, I think, might be very good for the all-the Lennard-powered cars as well. Leonid Roderick, car number 4, is doing battle with Adrian Devereaux. And now you see that second group of cars, which is now headed up by Chris Johans in the 12 car, is going to have Adrian Devereaux and Leonid Roderick probably working towards the front of it. Roderick in this number 4 car has had a lot of speed, not a whole lot of luck. Of course, Roderick won at Ohio. That's a track he's always excelled on. Oh, Yokoyama caught in a bad spot. At this point, it looks like the leaders are just catching him so fast that he really can't do anything. He just has to hold his line and hope that he doesn't get hit pretty much. And, you know, Yokoyama's actually done a pretty good job to be going as fast as he is in that car. But at this, Arto Kekkonen puts him in the grass. I think message sent and received. A bit unlike Arto Kekkonen, but I think the fact that Kekkonen hasn't won a race this year is kind of getting to him a little bit. I think that's where that bit of anger came from. Here is Kuznetsov. You have Jenny Kuznetsov. I'm a little surprised that Katsum Engineering didn't swap him into the Indianapolis race when Carlos Rocheda qualified and he didn't. I think that took quite a few people by surprise, because that's usually been the MO of the modus operandi, rather, of most all the teams Kuznetsov has driven for. That surprisingly didn't happen, but he's having a pretty good day today, so he's making up for that little blemish there, that miscue, missing Indy. Anna Percy has been looking to steal the Independence Trophy, at least with the pace she's showing tonight. She's running in 19th, so Percy having a fantastic day as she's now chasing down Chris Davenport. And there is Lewis Kingston in the 17 car, about to be lapped. Kingston now was involved in that lap 2 crash. Manicore Engineering pulled the front end off it and sent him back on track. Well, that's doing it old school. It's the way most of these teams still operate. Of course, you can't replace front clips in this series. That's one of the rules that they have in order to keep costs down. It's one of the ones that it sounds a bit odd as the leaders looks like they're pitting. Kevin Dwyer is 17, deciding to pit at the last minute. Wonder if, and there is also Adam Purcell in one of the Velocity cars is pitted. He's the lap down also. And Melanie Clavino staying out an extra lap. You saw in the background, Savaral hitting the pits. Peter Short in the 22 car, I don't think is pitted yet. Given the rate that Clavino's catching him at, I'd be surprised if he has pitted. His tire wear has been a rather big problem, especially for some of the teams further down the field. Leonid Roderick in car number 4. Good run off the... Nasova slow off the pits in car number 10. Roderick in the number 4 car looked like they didn't have the best pit stop there. We'll have to see how where he is when the field shakes out. And here is the leader, Melanie Clavino, car number 2. After she's pitted, well, Peter Short's still in the lead lap. Ash Bridges is still on the apron. And Kevin Dwyer has actually moved up into second place, as you see right behind her. And there it is confirmed. Kevin Dwyer in second place. He's always gone well in the high banked ovals, has Kevin Dwyer. Of course, he won at the one in Brazil, got his first win down there, and has always run well on some of the super speedways. And looking back in third in line, there's Benoit Boucler, but I think further back there, we'll see Adrian Devereaux popping into the frame. At least that's what I thought I saw back there. And here goes Kevin Dwyer in car number 8, and the Maya in the Maya soft car. No, that's Luciano Savaral in the background going around Lewis Kingston. Maya is playing tricks with me, obviously. as Kevin Dwyer in car number 8 trying to make a run on Melanie Klaveno. They've been side by side all the way down the back straightaway, and Kevin Dwyer leads the lap. So, new leader, Minnesota's Kevin Dwyer. Car number 8, he's going to clear Klaveno. They got lap traffic up ahead of him. And Yokoyama holding his line as he's being lapped by Ben Atkins. And Kevin Dwyer assumes the lead. Here's Chris Davenport, who's having a surprisingly good run. He's had a very clean weekend, which is not something I normally say about Chris Davenport. Captain Eyeliner going around. Oh, and D'Souza's in trouble. He was about to get passed by Gasper D'Souza, but the Darlington winner's in trouble. And Gasper, the Portuguese driver, out of the race after what looks like motor failure on car number 60. And that is a big disappointment for D'Souza, because I think he might have had a car that could have won this race. Scott Bates in car 88 running up in 9th place, chasing down Yulian Nasova. And that is 4th position. Nasova having a good race in car number 10. She's never won on an oval and never really done particularly well on them. But Scott Bates in this 88 car is actually one of the better drivers in this field. He's had quite a bit of success on ovals, road, you name it. Scott Bates has probably won on it. Or he's at least run very well there. Doesn't quite clear Nasova, but he's going to get the position at the line. And that's what counts as he clears Nasova. Yes, he's going to clear Nasova there. Klaveno's gotten the lead back in the meantime. With the little help from lap traffic, it should be said. Kevin Dwyer still second, and Luciano Savrol and Kurt Kliskin have reeled him in as a result. Kurt Reynolds in car 39 is running in 24th, and Daniel Melrose, the Mad Uncle, is running in 25th. He hasn't really been able to make up much more ground than he's already made up. Word salad there is Arto Kekkonen running in 13th. His night hasn't really gone particularly well. He's gone backwards, and Joe Lenick is in trouble again. If he didn't have bad luck, he'd have no luck at all. And poor Joe Lenick, this is another mechanical failure, and something needs to happen. He needs to have one race where nothing goes wrong, and I think he'll turn up with a decent result. He actually was running fairly well, given Star USA's fairly low expectations here. Kliskin going for the lead in car number 16. And he's hasn't quite cleared Klaveno, but he's got it now. Lap traffic ahead, that's Cameron Taylor from Ohio in car number 26. And then Richard Scott right up ahead. Richard Scott having a good race tonight. The Alona car of Klaveno trying to get around Kliskin. Not going to do it right there. There's Luciano Savrol behind Taylor. Ash Bridges' car is slowing down, and so is one of the Katsivs. I think that's Raketa. Yes, that's Rocky slowing down, but where the cameras here are focusing on Ash Bridges, the local boy. And there is Raketa's car, and looks like Carlos is going to be able to bring that car back to the pits. There he is going by Bridges, who's still going out there. Or was. Looks like Bridges is out and Raketa's out. How many laps down was Bridges when he... Bridges was well over 20 laps down, I think, by the time that car ran out of juice. Kliskin leads still. Klaveno still second. There's Kevin Dwyer, and there's Luciano Savrol, really right where we last saw them. And not a whole lot going on up here. Looks like they might be saving... If I'm Melanie Klaveno and I'm running behind Kurt Kliskin like that, I'm saving quite a bit of fuel, and I'm letting Kliskin... punch the hole in the air, and Klaveno is going to be using less fuel just by riding where she is, and Kevin Dwyer will be using less fuel as well, as will Luciano Savrol. So you wonder whether or not Klaveno is really in the catbird seat here. No, Melanie Klaveno wants to lead this race. You know, that or Kurt Kliskin suddenly lifted off the throttle a bit and decided that for Klaveno. There she goes. She's going to make a run on the 16, and she's going to clear him, it looks like. Coming down the back straightaway. Dwyer staying where he is. Now, Dwyer's got so much momentum, I think he doesn't want to waste it, so he's going to go on the inside of Kliskin and take second, or try to. And Adam Purcell, in the meantime, doesn't know what lane to get in. Adam Purcell has only one career start in the series. It was all the way back in 09. He's an Australian touring car star, and he is actually boxing Kliskin in, but he's got no... Oh, Luciano's done! The 5 car is up in smoke. Luciano Salvarol's night ends with a big explosion in the back. And that is a big disappointment for the Brazilian, as Adrian Devereaux now is assuming fourth place. From 24th on the grid, Adrian Devereaux in car number 7 making his way forward is Mason Yokoyama in the Lycoya Busters sponsored entry, I should point out. I think that's how Kurt Blitzkin's going to get by him. And Kevin Dwyer now boxed in behind Yokoyama. And that is not exactly what Dwyer needed. But he looks like Blitzkin's pitting on lap number 81. We've gone a long way. A long ways in. Yeah, there is Yokoyama pitting. There's a lot of the leaders around him. Roderick is in. Adrian Devereaux in. Tom Moore leaving the pits in the 19 car you see there. And here's Jack Dempsey, who actually has stayed out quite a while. The conservative Australian public figure, I guess that's the best way to put him, is having a pretty good debut, actually. Chris Johans puts his name on the lap leaderboard. He needs something good to happen to him this year. There's been some rumors that after the Australian tour, he might not be with Alert anymore. I don't know too much about that, but there's been reports that Robert Dorian will be in that car in Gravis City. We're not quite sure about where those rumors came from. There's actually been quite a bit of interesting rumors about the Gravis City race, and one of them concerns Melanie Klavenos, a former Team Lynx Racing, that they might not even be there because Lynx has failed to secure a business license in Gravis City, and Klavenos pulling to the inside. Is there a problem? Is there a problem with Klavenow? Looks like she might have a puncture after a pit cycle. That's a big disappointment for the Swiss driver. This is going to mean that Kurt Plyskin is now the leader of the race in car number 16. Plyskin to the front of the pack. And as you see there, Power Steering Incorporated nailed the pit stop, but he's got a killer shark chasing him down in the form of Adrian Devereaux. Kevin Dwyer is third. Chris Davenport's running in eighth in the 84 car. And he's having a terrific night in the SUA International machine, driving for the Michelin Suns, the oldest tenured team in the series. Been around like some 55, 56 years. Kekkonen trying to get around Davenport, but Davenport has got Inglesby Motors in this car. They might be pulling out after in a couple of years' time, supposedly, but Davenport is really making a case for them to stay around. Cameron Taylor in the 26 car is actually also having a pretty good night. He's running 18th at this point in that red and yellow machine. Kurt Reynolds just went a lap down not too long ago, but he's actually the last car in the points. Pretty good run for the TM Lights Hot Shoe. He's running 20th after getting such a late call to drive for Delgado de Garmo Enterprises. Kurt Reynolds has actually looked pretty good in this 39 car. He's done much better than that car's previous occupant probably would have here at Calder Park, as Yokoyama throws a block on the Lennard-powered Helsing, I should point out, of Jack Dempsey. Now, Jack Dempsey, knowing what type of person he is, might not take too kindly to that if he's held up for very long. Dempsey goes by the 97 car. Car 341, Dempsey having a pretty good race. Anna Percy running in 16th as the last car in the lead lap. Plyskin's Lycoya is the leader, as the leader of the race. And there's Yokoyama getting out of the way for Percy. And I think he just realized that his sponsor might not be terribly happy given who he just let go in that 16 car. Kevin Dwyer is trying to race with Adrian Devereaux here, but he just doesn't quite seem to have enough momentum to get on the inside of Adrian Devereaux. That 7 car of Devereaux really hooked up tonight. That car really going places. Ben Atkins in car 50 has been stuck behind Yokoyama here for about 5 laps, or I should point out. Ben Atkins just doesn't seem to be able to find enough momentum and enough speed to get by Yokoyama, and I'm a little surprised because just about everyone else in the field has. Adam Purcell has even found enough momentum to get by Yokoyama. But Ben Atkins really struggling with that at the moment. Oh dear. Oh, we got a huge train of cars here. I don't think any of them really know what's going on. Tom Moore, Davina Henton's back there. I think at this point, Henton's trying not to run over the car in front of her. And I think Moore is trying to do likewise. Ben Atkins, the only one legitimately, looks like trying to get out of line there, and maybe Scott Stoyler in the back in that 13 car. The Scott Stoyler will race anybody. Tom Moore's giving him a bit of a hustle. There he goes. There we go. Looks like someone might have told Yokoyama, because Ben Atkins, I don't think, looked like he was going to make that move on his own without Yokoyama moving out of the way for him. Ben Atkins had a bit of a rough couple of races. Davina Hinton going on by Ben Atkins without too much... might have been a fist waved at him, maybe. Tell him to hustle up. There's the other two Tino, driven by Benoit Vuclair, having no problems getting by Yokoyama, and without any help, looks like. So, strike against Atkins there. Adrian Devereaux going on by the 97 without too much help. The 97 car is boxed in Jack Dempsey. What do you make of that? Adrian Devereaux in car number 7, having a pretty good race. This is actually about 3/10 faster than the race leader, and he is reeling in Kurt Pliskin, who I think is having to push it at 100% in order to keep Devereaux behind him. And, now it's all over! It's all over for Pliskin! The motor's gone south! That's another Lennard! One was out in the pace lap, another out or mid-race in Luciano's car, and now Pliskin from the lead of the race! Oh no, that is a big, big heartbreak for Power Steering Incorporated, because he had a real threat to win this. He was a real threat to win this one because they've been killing it on pit stops. Oh no! Adrian Devereaux now leads the race with Kevin Dwyer pounding him all race long, but has not yet gotten by him. Dwyer now trying, but he's going to pit early. He's going to try to get pit a lap earlier and get around Adrian Devereaux in the pits. I think he might see that as the only way he can do it. They don't have too many laps left to go, so if the hot is Walter team... No! Oh, contact, slight contact with Richard Scott. Thankfully, everyone was paying attention. But the hot is Walter crew looks like they nailed it on the pit stop. I don't see Dwyer. Oh, no, Dwyer's a ways back. Kevin Dwyer looked like he got bogged down with a slow pit stop or a traffic or something, because he is well back of Adrian Devereaux, and he's going to need to really work hard to catch Adrian Devereaux, but it looks like he's going to run out of laps. White flag for Adrian Devereaux this time by. The Frenchman came back from 24th on the grid. We used to, a common criticism of Devereaux early in his career was that he wasn't very good coming through the field. He showed that particularly in 2010. He struggled mightily on some of the ovals coming through traffic, but he's put that stereotype to the grave. Adrian Devereaux wins in Victoria, coming from 24th on the grid to win. In a fantastic drive for Devereaux, leading 29 laps on his way to victory. Dwyer second, and Leonard Roderick soldiering through to take third place. Arto Kekkonen led 17 laps, but he'll have to settle with fourth. Scott Bates rounds out the top five with a very solid, quiet drive for the Oklahoma native. Ashby had a very uneventful race and came home 6th. Yulian Osova 7th. Greg Woodard, I think, might have had a motor going south in the last couple of laps, but he's brought it home in 8th and almost had to give up that position to Chris Davenport. And those 9 are the only drivers on the lead lap. Davina Hinton 10th. Stoyler, Andersson, Jack Dempsey in his debut comes home 14th place, a lap down. Hannah Percy and Dan Lecklider are doing their Independence Trophy bids quite a bit of good with their results tonight. Kurt Reynolds, Cameron Taylor, Dan Melrose, and Peter Short round out the points finishers. A double points for Melrose Racing Team at one of their 2 home races. I think they will be thrilled about that. Even though both of their cars in the points were 2 laps adrift, I think that doesn't make a bit of difference to them. One look at the Drivers' Championship shows that Adrian Devereaux has taken over the points lead, with Leonard Roderick moving into second. Savaral down to third. That DNF tonight didn't exactly help his case. Clavino still sits fourth in the championship. Kekkonen fifth. Ashby, Rossini, D'Souza, and Kevin Dwyer all still legitimate championship threats. I shouldn't count out Scott Bates in that 88 car, though, in 10th. Davina Hinton moves up to 11th in points. That's a good way to be, best of the rest, really. She's got, but I don't think anyone outside the top 10 has a legitimate shot to win the championship unless they win the Gravis City race and everyone in the top 10 in points doesn't finish the race. Evgeny Kuznetsov also moves up a couple of places in the championship. Of course, Ian Cooper, Jacob Card, both taken out fairly early on in the race, but Scott Stoidler is beginning to close in on those two. Stoidler's season has actually been getting a little bit better lately. One look at the Independence Trophy shows that Hannah Percy has not taken the lead away from Archer Harris. However, she will be at Surfers Paradise, and that will be very critical for Percy in order to take over the lead on the Independence Trophy. Because she started Indianapolis, she'll get more than four starts, and your best four results are the ones that count for the Independence Trophy, not counting promoters' options. Somewhat of a complicated system that'll probably get overhauled a little bit in the next couple of years, but that's what we have right now. Either way, we'll know the result of the battle between Percy and Harris for the Independence Trophy lead after the conclusion of the Australian Tour at the very famous street circuit on the Gold Coast. The TM Master Cup Series cars will be in attendance along with the Australian Touring cars and the Champ cars.